but a moment. Thank you for that beautiful presentation to the students and to the teachers who made that possible for all of us. So good morning, everyone. Morning, girls, and good morning, guests. So I welcome you to our annual St. Catherine's Day celebration. It always is a happy occasion when we gather together in St. Catherine's family to commemorate the founding of our school by Virginia Randolph Ellett, known fondly as Miss Jenny. It brings me great joy to warmly welcome all of our honored guests who join us today and to introduce you to some of these women. Specifically the women who in their senior year were elected by their classmates and faculty to bring St. Catherine's message to the school. So please stand when I call your names. Former head of the school and St. Catherine's representative, Auguste John Stannard. Barbara Blaine Burroughs. Lily B. Damgard. Current Director of Development and St. Catherine's Representative, Deborah Andrew Dunlap. Sarah Farnham. Lee Flattergrove Black. Carrie Featherstone Pope. Ann Kenny Urban. Patricia Brunel Long. Ann Dudley Percy Olson. Katie Wallmeyer Payne. If I've missed anyone or if you came in later, would you be willing to stand? Thank you. We're so pleased to have all of you with us today. So we take this time every year to share the story of Catherine of Alexandria, our patron saint. You heard her story told by our lower and middle school students, a story that we repeat every year. Not only is it a tradition, but it also is important that we remember her life each year and the virtues she exemplified. This gives us the opportunity to reflect on our own lives and on how we demonstrate those virtues in our actions. Just like all of you gathered here today, Catherine of Alexandria was a brave young girl who stood strong in her conviction. I challenge all of you to reflect on your own beliefs and to stay true to your values, just as St. Catherine did so many centuries before you. In St. Catherine's honor, this service also recognizes one senior who, by the vote of the classmates and faculty, best represents the ideals of Catherine of Alexandria: commitment to scholarship, determination, courage, hope, and faith. I will introduce this year's senior in a moment, and then we will have the pleasure of hearing from her. As a reminder, this service is held on or close to All Saints Day in order to give us the opportunity to honor and remember the lives of those from our St. Catherine's family who passed away in the last year. We remember them fondly for the many ways they enriched our lives and supported St. Catherine's School. The tradition of St. Catherine's Day goes back to 1924, when the junior class, along with our founder, Virginia Randolph Ellett, wrote a play portraying the life of Catherine of Alexandria. Our beloved Miss Jenny selected Catherine as our patron saint. St. Catherine's Day first took on the form of an elaborate pageant, but later was simplified to focus on St. Catherine's life and virtues. So before I introduce this year's special senior honoree, I invite today's honoree and her family, the former St. Catherine's Day representatives, the families of those memorialized today, our special guests, and our seniors, to reception in the Decote reception room following the service. In addition, I'd like to extend my thanks to the clergy and staff of St. Stephen's for their hospitality and hosting us today in this beautiful church. What a blessing it is to be in such a wonderful, wonderful building, filled with a lot of love and hope and faith in what we do. So now it is my distinct pleasure to introduce this year's St. Catherine's Day honoree, a St. Catherine's girl since kindergarten. Her second grade teacher described her as a delightful student and a joy to teach. Her love of life and sports is contagious and cannot be ignored. Her gentle, happy spirit added so much to our classroom. She approached each task with a positive and willing attitude. In middle school, she received a merit award in each of her 4 years. Mrs. Staley stated, "This is not surprising in her case. Her classmates noted that she is always inclusive, never says a mean word about anyone, and will go out of her way to support a friend in need. Her teachers describe her as a hard worker, humble, kind, and extremely respectful to both faculty and peers." In the upper school, this student continues to show commitment to her scholarship, earning strong grades, taking numerous honors classes and 2 AP classes in history, a subject that she loves. At the same time, she is fascinated by science and what it reveals about how the body works. Determined, courageous, and hardworking, when she didn't make the cut for an advanced team, rather than wallow in disappointment, she decided to redouble her efforts. Ms. Dayton noted that she became, because she was positive, she shows up every day, works hard, encourages others, and does not back down from a challenge. Few know the roadblock.